not to fool. And you can deal me in when it comes to a seltzer Pontiac. There ain't nothing like a seltzer deal.
Well, almost nothing.
Seltzer Pontiac, 5301 West Irving Park.
Put this on, okay? Now, smell.
Wildflowers? Oh, perfume.
It's Camay with a wildflower fragrance.
I love the smell of wildflowers.
You know how Camay makes your skin look soft and beautiful?
As beautiful as it smells?
Just beautiful and wild.
Wildflower fragrance Camay for a wild and beautiful feeling.
Sportmart, save. Velcro V-cut track shorts, all sizes and colors from $2.97. Niles, Lombard, Calumet City, Oaklawn. For sports, it's Sportmart.
An early morning fire that destroyed an apartment building in the 2100 block of West Huron is being investigated by bomb and arson units. Police were told by one of the residents in the building that the fire began when someone tossed a flaming wine bottle filled with gasoline into her living room. Fortunately, no one was injured in the extra alarm blaze, damage estimated at $50,000. Also Sunday morning, a fire in an abandoned five-story apartment complex at 41 East 47th Street caused heavy damage. Chicago firemen battled this extra alarm blaze for more than an hour before it was finally controlled. What caused the fire is being investigated. No reports of injuries. Evanston is getting Emmett's, and that's the subject of Roy Leonard's preview.
Is the Chicagoland area ready for another restaurant? Is the city of Evanston ready for a major complex that includes more than one restaurant? Tom Culligan thinks so. I guess he's the man behind a beautiful new complex here at Evanston called Emmett's. But why here, Tom?
Well, we're intrigued with the city of Evanston. We think this is a great community. And recently, within the last several years, why the liquor laws have been modified to allow, under certain conditions, a bar and lounge. And that's really one of the reasons for our being here. In addition to that, why we think that this American Plaza building is one of the finest facilities. It's the largest building between Chicago and Milwaukee. And so we think this is a great spot. And location for a restaurant is everything. You can change the menu, you can change a lot of things, but once you decide on the location, why, it's, you're pretty well locked into it.
Tom Culligan, telling us about Emmett's, a $2 million, 20,000 square foot restaurant complex here in downtown Evanston, named, by the way, for Tom's father, Emmett, the man who founded the famous water conditioning company. I'm Roy Leonard for News 9.
This is the start of National Secretaries Week, and 75 secretaries in Chicago will compete Monday in five 90-second events in their version of the Olympic Games. One event is the chain gang race to see who can construct the longest chain of paper clips.
John, your closet's full of clean shirts. What's so special about this one?
It's lucky. Every good meeting I've had, I've worn it.
Oh, come on, that's superstitious.
Come on, Linda, wash and iron it, please.
Well, I'll wash it, but I mean an iron.
Not iron it? Why?
Here's why. All Temperature Cheer has a new formula that actually reduces wrinkling while you wash. The shirt on the left was washed in the old All Temperature formula. The one on the right with new All Temperature Cheer. Our new Cheer won't eliminate wrinkles completely, but it'll help make them smaller, and many wrinkles will virtually disappear. So you may not have to iron. That's the difference new All Temperature Cheer makes. For best results, follow directions. Wash in the right temperatures.
That stuff works. Old Lucky's clean and doesn't look wrinkled.
Ever think it's not the shirt and maybe it's you?
Oh, yeah, maybe. But why risk it?
New All Temperature Cheer actually reduces wrinkling while you wash. New All Temperature.
At Al Johnson Cadillac, the concern for saving you money goes far beyond the price of the car you choose. We help many of our customers save money on money by offering financing at rates competitive with and often lower than your own bank. It stands to reason that a dealer selling so many Cadillacs has greater borrowing power, and at Al Johnson Cadillac, we pass it along to our customers. It's part of the extra care that makes a world of difference in your total satisfaction.
Al Johnson Cadillac, 8425 West 159th.
The Blackhawks season finally ended. Tony Esposito played another brilliant game, but the Hawks were beaten by the New York Islanders 3-1 in the fourth game of their playoff series. Dennis Potvin put the Islanders out in front with his first period goal at the stadium Sunday night. In the second period, this full-length rush set up a goal by Ed Westfall on a near-perfect play. 2-0 New York. And Mike Walton put the Hawks on the board with this goal, slipping the puck past Islander goalie Billy Smith. Mike Bossy adding the clinching goal for the Islanders in the third period. They won it 3-1. In other games, Montreal eliminated Toronto 4 straight. Another overtime game Sunday. Boston beat Pittsburgh 4-1. It was the Rangers over Philadelphia 6-0. And in baseball, Rick Rushel pitched a 6-hitter for his first victory of the season, as the Cubs beat Montreal 4-1 at Wrigley Field Sunday. Ted Sizemore provided a defensive gem with Tony Perez at bat in the second inning.
Sizemore with a tremendous dive. Now he has no time to measure the throw here. He's just got to make that frantic effort from one knee. There it is. Puts all he's got on it.
The game scoreless in the fourth when Dave Kingman batted with a man on.
That's pretty well hit. Back she goes. Stay fair, baby. Back.
Hey, a home run for Kingman. The Cubs lead by 2.
Cubs made it 3-0 on a sacrifice fly before Barry Foote batted in the 7th.
That's pretty well hit. That's way back there. Back.
Hey. Barry, my boy. It broke a window. That one broke a window.
Montreal got a run in the 8th to close out the scoring. The Cubs, now a 500 ball club with a 4-game winning streak, are off on Monday. They'll host Houston Tuesday afternoon with our broadcast starting at 1:15. At Cleveland, the Indians snapped the White Sox winning streak at 5 with the help of 3 home runs. And Cleveland also got some help from White Sox mistakes. After a pickoff throw hit the runner, Greg Pryor's relay was deflected by Francisco Barrios. In the third inning, Bobby Bonds put the Indians in front 3-1 with this drive into deep center field. And Barrios gave up another homer to Gary Alexander. Then Andre Thornton hit this 3-run shot to left field in the 8th. Lamar Johnson got those 3 back with this homer in the 9th off winning pitcher Rick Waits, but the Indians were victorious 8-5. Elsewhere, Baltimore beat Milwaukee twice, 6-2 and 7-6. The Yankees stopped Texas 5-1 on a 6-hitter by Ron Guidry. Mike Torres held the Royals to 4 hits. Boston blanked Kansas City 6-0. And Detroit beat Toronto on a 3-hitter by Dave Rosema. Minnesota over Seattle 3-1. Oakland ended California's 10-game winning streak 7-6. In the National League, the Mets got 4 in the 8th to beat Steve Carlton and the Phillies. Houston off to their best start ever, beat Pittsburgh 3-2. St. Louis rallied to defeat Cincinnati 4-3. Don Sutton struck out 12 as the Dodgers downed the Giants 9-2, and Atlanta beat San Diego 8-7. NBA playoff action now. A basket by Bobby Dandridge sent the Washington-Atlanta game into overtime at 109 apiece. In the extra period, Dandridge got 2 of his 31 points on this play to put the Bullets ahead by 2. Then 2 big jumpers by Kevin Greavy gave Dick Motta's team a 5-point lead in the final minute. Atlanta couldn't overcome that margin, and the Bullets took a 3-1 lead in the best-of-7 series. At Los Angeles, Seattle gained a similar 3-1 advantage over the Lakers. Freddie Brown scores here from deep in the corner as Seattle pulled away in the final period. Dennis Johnson scored on a layup coming up as Seattle won Game 4 of this series, 117-115. In other action, San Antonio beat Philadelphia 115-112. The Spurs lead that series 3-1. Phoenix took a 2-1 series lead over Kansas City as the Suns downed the Kings 108-93. Well, last week, Tom Watson narrowly missed winning the Masters. Sunday, a little consolation for Tom, the $54,000 first prize in the Tournament of Champions. Watson wasn't seriously challenged on Sunday. He won by 6 shots. This bunker shot on the 12th hole set up a short birdie putt that put Watson way out of reach. Bruce Litsky and Jerry Pate tied for second place in the Tournament of Champions.
Excuse me, I see you're buying one of those new extra low-price dishwashing liquids.
Mm-hmm.
May I ask why?
It costs less.
Have you seen this? A penny's worth of Ivory liquid washes more dishes than your brand.
Well, I don't know if that's really true. It's impossible for that little dab to do as much as the other one.
What would convince you?
Well, I'd like to see it happen.
Would you like to wash some dishes?
I wouldn't mind.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Why don't we wash some dishes and find out?
Our tests show mild Ivory liquid can be cheaper to use than an average extra low-priced liquid.
Mr. Foster, how are your suds holding up?
Well, they're almost gone.
How are the Ivory liquid suds?
I have lots left.
Scoop some up and compare. Okay, well, tell me what happened.
Ivory liquid cleaned more dishes.
What do you think now?
Wouldn't have believed it. Such a little bit did so many more dishes.
Do you still want to keep your brand?
Not really, no.
Why are you switching?
Saving money, plus it'll do a better job. Can't beat that.
Let me help.
Thanks.
I'll practice folding diapers.
Nope, I'm using Pampers now.
But you told me cloth was better.
That's before I tried Pampers. Now I wouldn't use anything else.
Cloth can't keep them as dry.
Really? Look, wet both, wait a minute, and slip in a blotter and you'll see. Pampers keep your baby skin drier.
And dryer's gotta feel better.
Pampers keep babies drier than cloth. Doesn't your baby deserve Pampers dryness?
Now Chicago's weather forecast for the beginning of the week. Tonight, fair with a low ranging from around 40 near the lake to the middle or upper 40s in the outlying areas. Monday, partly sunny and warm, a high in the upper 60s, but lower near the lake. Monday night, cloudy, warmer with a chance of showers, low in the mid-50s, but lower near the lake. Tuesday, cloudy with a chance of showers, high in the upper 60s or the lower 70s. Light variable winds tonight, light southeasterly winds on Monday, chance for rain 40% Monday night. Right now, it's officially 50 degrees at Midway. That's 10 Celsius, 49 degrees at O'Hare, 43 degrees along the lakefront. The relative humidity, 86%, and the air is calm. George Bauer reports on Newsbreak a little bit later. I'm Marty McNeeley for WGN News 9. Thank you for watching. Have a good day tomorrow.
Rain is here. Why doesn't my heart go dancing? Spring is here. Why isn't the waltz entrancing? No desire, no ambition. Nobody needs me. Spring is here. Why doesn't the breeze delight me?
The following is an editorial setting forth the views of WGN Continental Broadcasting Company. Speaking for the station, Corporate Vice President Alexander Field.
The Chicago Board of Education and the federal government are about to become locked in a legal battle which could be a long one. School Superintendent Joseph Hannon has chosen to fight charges that school officials have taken deliberate actions to keep the city's public schools as segregated as possible over the years. There's no question that most youngsters attending public school in this city do so in a segregated atmosphere, regardless of which definitions or standards for determining segregation are used. The key question, legally, is whether school officials have acted deliberately, as federal officials charge, to maintain segregation. Philosophically, the argument is immaterial. On the practical level, however, how it is resolved will affect whether we continue to receive federal funds and, more importantly, state money for our schools. Meanwhile, the federal officials who have suggested limited busing to pair and cluster schools here admit that such a program would leave nearly one-third of our school children in segregated school settings. Coupled with the continuing trend of lower enrollments, particularly among white youngsters, the question of deliberate action might be moot before it is resolved. However, Chicago needs that financial aid for its school system. The legal process must be speeded as much as possible.
The preceding editorial presents the views of WGN Continental Broadcasting Company. In keeping with our policy of fairness, we'll provide an opportunity for reply to qualified persons or organizations having opposing views. Copies of this editorial available on written request.
Yoo-hoo, Whipple!
Uh-oh, Hoffmeyer.
I'm letting them squeeze the Charmin in my store.
Hoffmeyer, are you crazy?
Ladies, measure how big and fluffy Charmin is.
Big and fluffy?
Charmin's so squeezably soft, it's irresistible.
Please, don't squeeze the Charmin. Hoffmeyer, in my store, nobody squeezes the Charmin.
Nobody but you, hypocrite.
Charmin, so big and fluffy, so squeezably soft.
It's irresistible.
I was flat till I went fluffy.
I was flat
till I went fluffy.
I was flat till I went fluffy with Pearl Concentrate. Just this much. Say these are hairs. Dirt and oil deposit in here and make hair go flat. Pearl leaves no deposits to flatten hair, so hair fluffs full like this and this. No shampoo leaves your hair fuller. Go from flat to fluffy with Pearl Concentrate.
Truckloads of quality Mohawk carpeting. Save $2 to $5 a yard for a limited time at Polk Brothers.
This is WGN Television, Chicago.